Hello.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to eCurious Minds Book Read Club. Here you are today to read Trevor's new book on assessments, Inquiry Mindset, Assessment Edition, Chapter 4. Session leaders are Nadia and Anupama. Over to both of you.
Thank you.
Please carry on. Rest of you can go on mute, please.
So friends, while the others join in, y'all can say hello in a language of your choice. Yeah, even if you don't speak that language, just try to say hello in a different language while the music plays on. Thanks, Anu.
Konnichiwa.
Yeah.
Bonjour.
Hello.
Okay.
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say.
Yeehaw.
Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break.
Guys, unmute yourself. Say hello to everybody. Hey.
I don't care, baby, by the way.
On some action, let's get a body moving.
Clap along if you feel like a
Now that we've all said our hellos and namastes and vanakams, is everybody here? Shall we begin, Miss Nadia? Miss Nadia?
Yes, Anupama, we can start.
Yeah. So, here is a small quiz. And y'all can speak out your answers, whether y'all agree, disagree, or raise sure reactions. If you agree, you can show thumbs up with the reactions. If you disagree, you can just show a thumbs down. Yeah? Okay, let's begin then. I do not see. Okay, I see a few thumbs up.
Anu, why don't you read the question aloud so that all of us can answer it together like a popcorn pops up? Yeah, okay. We'll all pop our answers. Yeah, that'll be fun.
Fine. Take it. Spiderweb discussions get the students up and moving about in the classroom. Agree or disagree?
Agreed.
Agree.
Louder, everybody together.
Agree.
Choose a strategy you would use to scaffold a large group discussion. Will it be Flipgrid or rehearsal time? Loud together.
Rehearsal time. Yeah.
Well done. How is what you're hearing different from your thinking? How is it you are hearing the same? Will you use the above question to encourage student talk, agree or disagree?
Agree.
All in unison, huh? Agree. Superb. Yeah. Well done. Okay. Observing and taking notes while moving around is an effective way of evidencing and assessing the learning happening in class. Agree or disagree?
Agree.
Oh, well done. We are all on the same page, all inquiry teachers. Through this routine, students have richer list of ideas. Okay, QFT is an acronym for question formulation technique, or give one, get one.
Give one, get one.
Give one, get one. Pat your bags. Well done. Okay, over to you, Miss Nadia.
Thank you, Nipama. So I can see in the chat a few have really liked this popcorn strategy. Yes, it really works wonders in class, and everybody gets a turn to speak. You know, that we're talking about the power of talk today. You know, without taking too much time, because today Anu and I are the host, but we are the guide on the site. And, you know, we want to embrace the power of talk to all our participants today. So we'll be moving into our breakout rooms. I'll just tell you what is to be done in our breakout rooms. You have a few discussion prompts as task one, because you've got two tasks to do. So please manage your time. Yeah, the first task is, you have to look at some of these prompts that are given here. We've used the golden circle, Simon Sinek golden cycle, to frame these questions. So have a read. I'm not reading them now, just to save some time for your breakout room. But to do this exercise, we'll be using the Diamond 9 strategy. I'm sure all of you are aware of it, and I've sometimes used it in your class. If not, do try it out. And this, you know, what you do is you have 9 pieces of the diamond, and you will be placing the greatest idea from the group, the top 3 on the top 3 chart, yeah? And the rest you can put below. So you need to have a negotiation in your team as to, you know, which are the top 3 ideas. And Anupama is trying to open the screen. Anu, can we go back to the previous slide, please, so that I can take them through the second task also?
Okay, I just wanted to show them the diamond screen.
Okay, please.
Yeah, so can you see the current screen?
Yes, visible.
Okay, we can fine. See. Okay, great. I'll just go back to the other one then. Yeah.
We'll put the link in the chat, Anu, so that they can, move to that screen later. Yeah, while you're in your breakout rooms. And the next task is, can you move to the next screen, Anu, please?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, now for the next task is where you're going to use your paper and pens that I kept asking you all for. Thank you, you know, for bringing all the supplies to this room. You have to create a catchy hashtag. Now, this can be done individually, or if you want, you can do this as a group, and also create a logo for this particular chapter, part of talking and assessment. You can use the visible thinking routine, think, ink, and share. Yeah, and this is going to be by your safe space. That's in your canoe. That's in your small group setting. And if you see to the left on the screen, I have created my hashtag and my logo there. So that's a microphone stating hashtag equity by voice. Okay, so you can create your own hashtag and logo for this particular chapter. Pallavi, I think without wasting too much time, you can start, moving them into, say, about 5 each in a breakout room. We're a group of 41. So you can make maybe 6 to 7 in a group, Pallavi. Any questions, friends, so far? I mean, I was just rushing you through the slides because, you know, just keeping track of time. That's the reason, so that you get enough time in your breakout rooms to discuss with your colleagues. Pallavi?
Sure. So,
Nadia, will the instructions be available?
Do you want me to create 6 breakout rooms with 6 to 7 participants? Yes. All right.
We'll do.
I'm opening up the rooms.
Yes. No, before you open up, I just want to share. One minute.
Sorry, don't join me.
Don't join the link, because I will share the link. You all will all have your, as per your group numbers, there are slides. You will access only that slide. So if you're in room number 1, you will write only on the room number 1 slide. Yeah. So I'm just sharing the link on the chat box.
And friends, when you come back, you have to share your top 3 and your group hashtag and logo. So you can rehearse, you. Use the rehearsal time.
Thank you. Now you can all proceed to the breakout rooms. Yeah. Thank you.
Hello.
Hi.
So let's start discussing what, why would we recommend our colleagues to unlock the power of talk? So the reasons behind that, why would we want them to use it?
So can you hear me?
Yes, very much.
One of the reasons I feel is, you know, that all learners do not talk when it is an open discussion.
One of you can open up that shared screen and start typing simultaneously. You don't have time.
All we can do is, Sapna, right now we can just put the
I'll just put it in any. Okay.
Hena, then maybe we can, if we feel, then we can copy paste it later.
Saps, I think first thing you can put is, as Sonia said, no? That whoever does the talking is likely doing the learning. I think you can put that first, I think.
Share the screen so that everybody can see.
Yes, yes.
Share, yeah, share. Yes. That
would be a good idea, Sapna. Screen,
yeah.
Sharing. Just a minute.
Yeah.
Can see?
Yes, it has started. Yes. ये छोटा लग रहा है ना सपना मिल
एक मिनट एक 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 ही मिनट एक ही मिनट मैं बड़ा कर देती हूँ ठीक है अब दिख रहा है
या नहीं हमें दिख रहा है but in that diamond I'm
I'll increase it
yes
हाँ yes
And I think also somewhere it was mentioned, no, that take a small group and.
Yes, exactly.
Yes.
Yeah. So that will come to the
not
second.
More than three. Yes.
Yeah. Small group. Start with the small group.
And see, look at the prior learning. Look at the prior learning. Give them opportunity.
That will come in the, yeah, Meena, that will come in the second question that she's asking. How will you encourage a strong discussion? Is starting with a small group. But do we have
basically,
any more ideas?
I think Sonia, here we need to just concentrate on why would you encourage your colleague to basically, go ahead and talk. I think this
we
also
need more ideas
students,
for that.
I think we also can also add that students get agency and they become more confident. I think that's a very important thing.
Yes.
And, when children start talking, they just feel that their voice is heard and they become confident. I think that is an important thing.
I think the word student agency said it all.
I think, Sapna, I mean, self-efficacy is a good word to use.
Yes.
They basically, that also can be put into that. Yeah, self-efficacy, you can put that.
Yes.
Most impactful.
Why would you encourage? So if I, if I'm an inquiry teacher and if I have to tell a new teacher who has joined, that why do you encourage the power of talk?
To develop
curiosity.
Guys. One point here. To develop perspective.
Yeah. Being perspective open. And curiosity also, Pallavi.
Yes.
In fact, when a child starts talking, he becomes more curious. So I think curiosity.
That could go on the second point. How would you create strong classroom discussions? How will you bring more students into the classroom? So curiosity.
Curiosity will be the first one. For the first one, Sapna, this is why would you want to encourage talk in the classroom?
Your conferences.
Yes, to embrace the intimacy of one-on-one conference.
One-to-one conferencing.
Oh, this is giving trouble to type in.
It's hard, yeah.
It's okay. You can the text. Yes.
Yeah. No, just,
yes. Increase the diamond size. It's going to work. Very interesting. Very, very interesting. Mm-hmm. Very well planned.
Thank you, Pallavi.
What has happened?
Friends, anything else? Yeah, we moved to the other slide, Matt. You need to come back to three. Yes. something else, anything else that comes to your mind, while you read this chapter that you would, would make a difference in your classroom, or you would want to recommend it to any of your colleague?
I liked the rehearsal time, because I think that gives a lot of power.
That's what I said also.
The rehearsal time. Okay.
Rehearsal time, and also thinking routines, the way in this chapter.
What are the advantages of doing? Using the strategy, you mean to say? Correct, correct. That discussion, yes, you have to support your girls. Share your screen, let's see what you all are typing. Yeah, we can do that. Anubhama, very well thought of engagement, very well thought of. Luckily, we have to really rack our brains, you know, to come up to that filling in only the nine diamonds. I got two to three answers wrong.
There's strategy inside the strategy. There is a golden circle, and we have to fill in
the time. Whoever is typing, quickly share your screen, please.
Yeah, Gayatri, I'll do that.
Hi, Pallavi, so good. I'm so happy I'm here. I'm doing something so nice. Thank you so much, Pallavi.
Both of us are going to be co-teachers in the same class in the coming season.
Yes.
Wow. In case I lose my connectivity because lights are fluctuating and there's a storm coming, in case I lose, then you keep continue the one of you continue.
Yes, yes. Absolutely.
Since I don't work so much with Zoom, I don't know if I'm sharing the right screen or not. Please excuse me on that.
Yeah, you are. You are.
You are sharing now.
So how do I go?
So should I first read all the three prompts so that we can come up with better ideas?
Yes. Now you see.
First one is why would you recommend a colleague to unlock the power of talk in his or her classroom?
Yes.
The second point is how would you create strong classroom discussion? How will you bring more student talk into the classroom? So over here we need to show the techniques what we want to use. And the third prompt over here is, what practices would you like to commit to? Pick a few that will become over time cultural practices you're committing to putting into practice. So I think over here they are talking about the culture, the routine which we want to set when we are just listing down the strategies which we are going to use in order to, unlock the power of talk. From those, we need to just pick up one or two which we think that we can, set as a culture in our classrooms.
From his book, he's given some strategies from his book.
He's given,
right?
Perfect.
I just gave you all one exemplar of one strategy for
Yes.
Circle time also can enhance the group thing. Circle's time can be one of the strategy.
Exactly, like think, pair, share is one of a very, I mean, I find it very interesting and it works with my children. It works. Other times also work with my children. They feel free to talk and that's something very nice and sweet. They like it.
Also, read aloud times can be used.
Exactly,
And, children love to read, so those reading times also, dear time, what we call, and we use in our classroom, it really helps, They talk so much and they love to speak about whichever books they are reading or what they understood from the characters, how the characters are building up in the story. It's fantastic using read alouds.
The time it was the manual classrooms, at that time there was a strategy which I normally use, that's EEK. So EEK also works really well. Yeah, we do. We say eye to eye, knee to knee.
Okay.
So the kids turn around to their friends and then they actually communicate with each other. So that really works well. That's
how we elbow to elbow is my favorite.
To elbow or shoulder partners.
But how about virtual?
War also works well. When kids discuss, I had this in my class, migration. The tug of war was really nice. where, you know, the kids of grade 3 had in, were in favor and were in against, like, you know, it
really action B. We could have a ladder. We could, I mean, a picture could be a ladder before scaffolding, but we could put it as don't miss a step or
climb to heights,
support, push to
climb up to heights or something, or reach
easy to reach.
Why are you easy to require? No hustle happening in this group.
Sorry?
Or sky.
No, how about sky is the limit happening in the group? No talk.
How about we are talking? Hello.
Yeah.
I hate
Okay.
Sky is the limit. The visible to everyone is the. I'm on my screen. Yeah. I can't see if it's.
So we can't see the screen.
One of you can please share the screen and hurry up, please. This group is so
should
fire.
I get the screen?
Yeah. No right. Excitement building up, creating the logo, working on.
Yeah, I'm busy writing, filling it up.
We're trying to fit this in.
To fit into those diamond shapes.
Yeah. So we have concluded that all of these are important and cannot really be ranked. And based on the kind of group that is working and the task that has been allotted, a particular technique would be more visible, more effective than the others.
Yeah. Okay, guys, we are forgetting the task of designing our logo.
Yeah, I think we should
start with that. Yeah, please. Okay, what do you consider to be
I believe that talk is influenced by
attention span is
so
very limited.
That
no?
can
so
be
yes,
the least.
Yes.
So that can be the least, and peer least assessment we can move it up, right?
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Okay.
Even think-pair-share should be moved up.
I hope you're factoring in. You have to design a logo and hashtags.
Yeah, we'll move to the next one.
Yes.
So come on, quick. I think we have to hurry up.
Anupama,
I am set. I am set. Yes.
Yeah. How much more time do we have?
I think we can give them 5 more minutes. Yeah.
Really? Right. That's it?
Videos are least impactful. Okay, correct.
Yeah.
Y'all want more time for the logo and hashtag?
Let's
go for the logo.
Let's go. Miss Nayada, you want to do the logo since you're doing a lot of drawing right now? You want to try doing the logo? Come on. Yeah?
I can try.
Come on, please. Let's begin.
Any ideas, I can try.
Yeah. You've got some new good ideas.
And the hashtag? Hashtag?
Yeah, what hashtag?
Somebody think about the hashtag. Yeah.
We'll think about the hashtag.
Can we...
Chatter matters. That's a good one. Instead of a mic, what do we want to put? Anything creative, something different?
It's talking person.
Okay,
I just made this.
It's a chatter, so maybe bird beak or something you can put.
I just finished that video thinking, so I can
made this
apply that thing.
With Piyush,
yeah.
Wow. Nice. Again, thought.
Gayatri. Yeah.
Very nice.
This is also nice.
Yes.
Nice. Talk and sort. That's a nice
talk
one.
Talk
and sort. Yeah.
Cool. Talk and sort. Nice. Very nice.
Good. what have you had?
Lovely.
Start chalk and sort. Yeah, you can chalk out your heart and you can sort everything that's inside you.
Super. Yes, everybody had this sensibility.
Pour your heart out. Yeah. Lovely.
That's nice.
I think we are done, yeah?
Yeah. The speaking is the one who's doing the thinking. So something on that part we can, you know, do a thinking hat or a something.
I hope you remember you have to design a logo in the next 3 minutes and have tags.
Whoever is doing the talking is likely doing the learning. That was
learning, So something like, you know, on that basis, if you could design
creative group, everyone talking, and that can be our logo.
Yes.
Everyone talking, and everyone we can show thinking that way. Something
like can be like a brainstorming.
Yeah, kind of. So where will we get the logo? How we will design on paper?
You hardly have time.
Yeah, you can draw quickly in a paper and then take a picture and upload over there. I think that will be more quick.
Rez, you need to show your face.
Yes. I turned on my camera before. Now I am eating. That's why I don't want to.
Yes, can you? Who suggested? Can you just draw and take a picture and put it quickly?
I'm very bad at drawing picture, miss.
Who's put this? Okay.
This one is nice.
Instead of taking an internet one, why don't you quickly draw, click a picture and put it there?
Whoever is good at drawing, can we draw? The image is here, but
I'm not good at drawing.
Only 2 minutes left. I'll close the room, okay?
Hashtag. What are we putting for a hashtag?
Talkers are
something one word that is goes with like brainstorming, like discussion, something.
Walk and talk.
Just walk one word will do. I think
talk and learn.
Something like that. Like
talkers
and talk. Yeah, that is nice.
Talk to learn.
Learning by talking. Learning.
Learning talks.
Another word for talk. Can we think about that? Another word only for talk.
Active discussion. Active in discussion.
Like sharing is caring. We do something like that. Sharing by learning. Right.
To give some like catchy word, you know, like.
Oh, breakout room is ending.
We
arrange according to the
talking tom.
Type anything. 2 seconds left.
Talk the thought.
Yeah, that's
nice.
Talk the thought.
Okay.
I'm inserting that, okay?
Interesting, huh? Lot of hustle and bustle in couple of rooms. Some of them were quiet. Lovely work, Nadia and Anubhava.
Beautiful. They're all back. Are they all back? I can see 47. Great. Okay. So, Pallavi, you can be the timekeeper. We'll give them about 2 minutes each to share their top three, from the diamond template and their hashtag and logo.
Done.
So, any one presenter from each breakout room. We'll start, which was the last one, Pallavi? Was it breakout room number 6 or 5? How many did we
have? 6.
So, let's start with 6.
Yeah, give me a moment. I'll just share my screen.
Hurry up. Time starts now.
Okay, so what we decided was doing the talking is likely doing the more learning. The child is, talking more and he or she is making more connections and hence more learning more. Then we went on to the rehearsal time that will help them to learn. Then definitely a flip grid to reflect on and where they can collaborate and discuss whatever they want to, or during the unit, they can share their videos and they can speak and they can reflect on. Then we have small group discussions, the way we can that has actually helped all of us to learn better. And then to encourage reflection, yes, definitely. While the book also said, while during learning the unit or having the unit in the journey, they are reflecting in the, you know, on their learning. So that is also very important, reflection. The visible thinking theme, to make the thinking visible, is very important. So that is how then, can someone else also help me for SWT, please? So I think that is how we think they are more valuable.
Also, what we think is that though all these you know, strategies have their place, and we cannot really put them in the diamond, in the order of most effective or the least effective or least important, because based on the task at hand and the student group that we are working with, the effectiveness would be decided by that. So all of them are important, and based on the task and the student group, we decide what would be most suitable at that time.
Group number five, that's their hashtag and logo.
Hashtag and logo is here.
Yes, the Wi-Fi signal, okay, which shows connectivity, powerful connectivity. It's not physically present, but it's always there. And
sorry, your time is up. Your time is up. It's beautiful.
Lovely. Okay, 1 second. On paper, our diagram looks like this.
Lovely. So lovely.
Beautiful. Wow. The questioning is also there. Good, thinking good. And writing up, everything is there.
Awesome.
Okay. Friends, so number five, use the emoticons to express. Yeah, we can use the emoticons to appreciate.
Sandeep, yeah. Go for it.
All right. Share my screen.
Anupama, actually, you should have shared the screen so that, you know, everybody can.
Shall I share? Okay.
Yeah. I think that'll be better. We'll save time on everybody.
Yeah, it saves a lot of time. Please do that. Very impactful session, let me tell you that, both of you.
Thanks, Pallavi.
You're welcome, Nadia. Guys, please move.
All right, so
speaker will speak.
So when we were discussing, we also realized that you know, there are some strategies which are age group specific, and it depends on the task, but still we have written it in the order. So first goes debate, because it gives a lot of opportunity for everyone, you know, to discuss their ideas and brainstorm together. Then there are other strategies like QFT, Spiderweb, VTR includes all the visual thinking routines. And at times, small peer groups also work. For example, you know, there is a connect with, you know, two or three students, so they might work effectively. So small group formations, layers, you know, which helps in inquiry, then TED Talks and Flipgrid also. And we have made three logos and three hashtags. So the first one is voice, not echo. And it's an amplifier sign. There is a speech bubble. So, you know, for example, right now I'm talking and you all are listening. So my voice is getting amplified. You are able to process it. Then there is a ladder which says hashtag reach for the skies. It's about exploring, you know, all the dimensions of whatever we are talking, concept, knowledge. And then there is this Mother Earth, exploring the realms. When we talk about the, you know, mental core of Earth, you know, we are again discussing and you know, going beyond the horizon. So yeah, that's all. Somebody can cover if I have missed something.
No, thank you, Sandeep. I think you've covered it all.
Good.
And in time, that's great.
Before time, that's wonderful.
Before time.
1 minute.
As they say, Sandeep,
This joke is a little on men. As they say, men are a few less words and women are with more words. So you have proved it correct.
Yeah, I'm glad group six, you know, came before us, went before us. So I you know, it had in my mind that I have finished before.
Great. Let's go to group number four. Hurry up. Okay, let's start. Speaking. Group
Gayatri,
four.
You want to go? Please go ahead.
Oh, yeah. Yes. Sorry, we did not put our logo and our hashtag there. It is on my notebook, so I can share it after it. So, yes. So what we felt is when we allow children to speak, we allow better collaboration amongst them. Something which came up very high for us is think, pair, share, that we feel that this strategy really works. And yes, Flipgrid, we have tried. Personally, I did not try it, but I'm other teachers, they have. But yes, I am now interested to try it in my class. Certain things that we have to keep in mind that when we allow collaboration, when we allow children to speak, we create a friendly environment, a positive environment, which is very important. We try to build a learning environment when we allow children to speak, we give them agency. Certain things that that does not work for us and we discussed and we feel that these are very passive. So we feel that sometimes the videos that we show in the class, they do not work. So we have kept it at the bottom of the diamond. Jigsaw reading, it's very structured and there is nothing much for the children to express. So we have kept it. We also felt that peer assessment, it works in the class because we allow children to speak. And when children speak, though we remind them that you have to be kind with your friends, they speak in a very constructive way that, hello, you could have added this and this. So I feel that this is a very strong way. They are you know, very actively involved in their learning. So we all agreed and we have put up these points. And our hashtag and our symbol looks like this, if you can see.
Yes.
Sorry, I took a little bit.
Just bring it to the center. Yeah.
Zoom it now.
Super.
Yeah, so the hashtag is talk and sort. So sometimes, you know, we have a lot of issues, basically children, they have a lot of issues. So when you talk, you sort those issues. So it's not only a learning engagement, but you emotionally get strong. Thank you.
Oh,
that's it.
One minute, 57 seconds. Woohoo!
Yay!
Good job. Group number three.
Okay, I think that's me. Going to wait for the slide. Here we go. Okay, we thought we moved these diamonds around a little bit after we got our words inside the diamonds. Excuse the skewed diamond shapes, but we had thinking routines at the top and then followed by discussion and planning the next steps, which of course informs the learning experiences and general talk from there on as well. Modeling and scaffolding we thought was very important from the teacher to the students and students onto other students possibly. Guiding questions also important. Trevor's mentioned those quite a lot. Rehearsal time, and again, as other people mentioned, a safe friendly environment, you have to nurture that. Collaboration is obviously also key. Praising students. Again, if you need them to talk more, you need them to praise more so they can feel safe and feel valued to share their thoughts. And the last one we had was one-to-one conferencing, which often very, very powerful to hear students what they are thinking towards their learning one-to-one. Does somebody else want to talk about the logo and the...
Asha, would you want to go? Asha?
Yeah. So basically we thought of this and we put this as make me talk. So actually, since the entire thing is about speaking and how the person who's doing the speaking actually is doing the learning. So it's designed by one of our teammate and she's actually put it there like help me or make me talk.
Ruchi, you would like to add something since we have a few seconds left?
Asha did it very well. Thank you, Asha.
And this is drawn by Ruchi.
Hi, ma'am. Well done. Well done.
And actually, both the Ruchis had contributed to one for drawing and one for making the hashtag.
Beautiful. Yeah. Lovely.
Group number two. Group two.
Sapna, you'll go. Sapna, Nina, Nisha.
This is one of the most organized diamond.
Sorry. I think somebody else can take a chance this time.
Give chance to people who don't come forward.
Nina?
Miss Meena?
Nina.
Miss Meena? Chalo, she's counting the time.
Hurry up!
Okay, so again our group also felt that we were not all the strategies for each one of the questions. We have arranged it like this, so it actually is not in an order of most impactful and least impactful. Why we would like to encourage our colleagues is because, like he says, Trevor, whoever does the talking is doing the learning. Why is because the competencies, that whether you call them the 21st century skills or what he talks as competencies and dispositions, will be developed when the students talk and discuss, and because it is student agency when they talk. For the second, this thing is how you would do it is, I think, again, starting with small group discussions where students feel confident and comfortable. Classroom arrangements can be done in such a way that in small groups, and again there the agency can be given to the students. Scaffolding from the small group discussions where the meat of the discussions happen, moving on to the larger group where they share and reflect, because you learn when you reflect, not when you're doing. So that we felt was very important. How we will do it, the strategies our team discussed, our group discussed, is the VTRs, again, the visible thinking routines are very important. Choosing the relevant ones for different engagements to bring out the depth in the learning. Again, here students can be given a choice. I think student agency is through everything. Again, co-designing and co-constructing the learning experiences and the learning environment, both. So I think this is a must in every teacher's this thing. And two strategies, rehearsal time and Flipgrid. So we've realized, we discussed and we realized, yes, the power of Flipgrid, whether we have used it or not used it before, everybody agreed that they wanted to have it as a part of their toolkit and explore it. Our hashtag and logo, you can see over here. So it's it's a team of students together, like Pallavi says, together we are better. And hashtag voice by choice. Anyone wants to add anything?
Sapna? Time up, ma'am. Time up. You take 3 seconds. Very well done. Thank you.
Superb.
Superb. Lovely.
Amazing hashtag. That's my favorite. Thank you. I'm going to use it if you allow.
Of course you can.
Group one.
Hello. May I go ahead?
Please do. Your group is your time is on.
Okay. So as Sonia had also mentioned, we have not ordered things according to from the most impactful to the least impactful, but these are some of the strategies and why we would make the thinking visible. So first is, why would we propose to our colleagues, okay, to give importance to talk in the classroom? Because this helps in making the thinking visible of the learners. And for that, of course, we would be using different visible thinking routines to make the thinking visible. This also gives a choice of expression to the learners, how they want to express themselves. Okay, it helps a facilitator to understand the learners better. What are their passions? What are their strengths? What are their stretches? So it gives a better understanding to the facilitator about the students. How we would do it is, of course, small group discussions, because that is very powerful in enabling every learner to speak out, and then going on to the whole classroom discussions. It also enables the facilitator to understand the prior knowledge of the learners, which helps the facilitator to then plan ahead the learning engagements, keeping the prior knowledge in mind. Effective use of guiding questions. So it that is something, you know, the guiding questions helps the learners to take the discussion further. And of course, praises, like Trevor had mentioned, even a simple nod, you know, or a smile encourages the group or the learners that they are going on the right track and to proceed. So yes, praising the learners and acknowledging what they are sharing. And of course, using strategies like Flipgrid, small group, you know, each one share one. So these are different strategies which we would want to use.
Time out.
And okay, our logo is like, you know, a group discussion, people, learners talking and, you know, sharing their thoughts. And the hashtag is Talk the Thought.
Very nice.
Okay, I wanted to add something. I created this logo for our group. You can check.
Wow. Okay. Wow.
Closer to the camera, Parul.
Yeah. Is it visible?
Yeah, it's beautiful.
You've made use of all the colors. Great.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Thank you. Thank you. Anupama, you can have our main presentation on the screen now. You're on mute.
Yeah, I'll just share the main presentation. Just a minute.
Thank you.
I will also share our meeting ID for Trevor, and we will log in around 6:50. If you want to log in before, most welcome. But after 7 o'clock, no logins.
So friends, you know, we've used one grouping strategy here. If you've noticed earlier when we were in the breakout room, we said we used a metaphor that we are by the canoe. And you know, when you came back from the breakout room and when you were sharing your thoughts and ideas that you discussed in your canoe was by the campfire, because you know that was a larger group sharing. So from a small group setting to a larger group setting. Now what we're going to do is we're going to use another metaphor, that is we're going to move into our cave. Okay, that's your personal space. That's your personal reflection time. So now, you know, we're going to use this tool Flipgrid, since a few of you mentioned during your presentation that you haven't yet tried out Flipgrid. So today you have this opportunity to have the feel of using Flipgrid. We'll do this live. All of us will record our videos live today in the last 10 minutes that we have for this session. So we are on time, Pallavi, and we're hoping to finish even this engagement on time. We thought if we won't be able to manage, then we will put it as an asynchronous task. But, you know, bingo, we are able to do this on time. I'll just take you through the engagement. You know, you have heard a lot of your colleagues, your participants here share about their understanding. At the same time, you must have also connected while reading the chapter. To some of the practices that you're already doing, you must have, you know, thought of what you want to do next. So keeping all those thoughts in mind, we want you to use the strategy here as the circle, triangle, and the square to reflect. So the square is, you know, what are the ideas or what are the beliefs that have squared with you? What are the three things that have triangulated with you? And, you know, if there's any question or any thought that's circling in your mind, you need to put that. You know, you can ink it first if you want, because you have a few minutes to rehearse and then you can start your recording. While I'll request Anupama to put the link for Flipgrid into the chat box. When you're using Flipgrid, please join in as a guest login. Yeah. So use the guest login and click on the Flipgrid link. The password is chapter 4. Anupama, if you move to the next screen, they'll be able to see the link and the password too. So Anupama has already shared the Flipgrid link. You can click on it. Take your time to rehearse and then you can go and record. So we get about 7 minutes to record this and we come back on this main screen. Yeah. So have you all got the link for Flipgrid? The password is chapter 4.
Yes, it's there in the chat box.
And please join in as guest. Otherwise, you won't be able to log in.
Shall I share the demo where they have to sign in, or it's okay, everybody can do it?
Yeah. I think, are they able to log in? Then we can save those minutes. I mean, if...
Yeah.
Are we able to log in?
Perfect.
I'll just just share my screen and show y'all. Once you click on the link, you will get this option, enter your guest password. Don't click on any of these, join with Google, join with Microsoft. Click on this, and then you just have to write chapter 4. Oh,
Pallavi, you can open the eye so that they can see the password.
Okay. So now once you've gone over there, there's this tag over here, this caption, record your response. Once you click on it, the video will come. Yeah. And you can start recording. Yeah. Fine.
Any questions, anybody?
5 minutes.
I mean, will it open my camera? Will it allow my camera to open once I'm like, I am on Zoom, and will it allow Flipgrid? Will it allow? Okay. I'll try. Okay.
Just try. Otherwise, you'll have to just shut your camera and then see if you can do Flipgrid.
Can you just show the task what we have to do?
I will just share again.
Since it's there in the Flipgrid, when you open it, the questions are displayed there.
Thanks.
Okay,
if you all switch off your cameras, you all will be able to record on Flipgrid right now itself. Just switch off your cameras. Only then the camera can access. No?
Nadia and Anupama?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
It's almost time, so they can finish and then post.
Sure.
Okay. Cameras on. Thank you, Nadia. Thank you, Anupama, for this beautiful, impactful session. It was very informative, and what thoughtful strategies, what learning engagements. Bravo. It's one of the best sessions I have attended. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I was rushing too fast just to finish it on time. So I'm sorry about that.
It's brilliant. I think we should learn from you, from both of you, how to be punctual and how to manage time so effectively. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Miss Nadia.
Thank you, everybody.
Pallavi, I have some posters for everyone on Spiderweb, because I saw a few people have questions and I've curated a few posters. I'll post it on our WhatsApp group.
And please, everybody can go and watch the video on YouTube. These are our social links. Use the hashtags and please keep posting.